Thank you very much, Domenico. It's now very hard after this wonderful and genius presentation to come up with maybe less exciting but also important things. So I'm talking about the ESSA opportunities on the way to career success. And I would like to show you a bit about the concept of ESSO, and Domenico already introduced the topic, and the strategic plan of ESSO is to create a surgical oncology, or they created surgical oncologist, and the goal is to get this one day set up in the societies, in the national societies, that this is an accepted degree or that is an accepted certificate. We are not there yet, but the surgical oncologist has a central role, the surgeon, and to diagnose and to treat cancer patients, and he's an independent surgical specialist. And if you just see here, there are many fields ESSO is covering. So we have in the ESSO, I start maybe here at the bottom line, the research collaborative. Domenico showed you the first ISAC study, the Corsica trial from Laura Lorenzo from Rome. We have several ways to collaborate in the Young Surgeons Forum in the ISAC, and we have the steering committee has every specialty you can imagine. So we have urologists, we have gynae oncologists, we have breast surgeon, we have colorectal surgeons, upper GI surgeons, and we are very close together working on our goals. And one of these aspects is the research. So we conduct trials and to share also data to get bigger sample sizes. Different other things, I come in the next slide, so about Congress and education especially. And you see education, we have in ESSO, or ESSO provides several components in education. As I already showed you, in my case, a fellowship or bursaries. So you have the possibility to apply for fellowship grants in ESSO when you are a member of the ESSO, and they provide you financial support in either going to congresses or also doing short fellowships in some cancer centers. We have the segment of the courses and the master classes. ESSO provides several courses and also conducted or set up two different schools, like the European Society or the European School of Peritoneal Surface Oncology, or also a sarcoma school, which is very interesting because you're getting specific training, and especially countries like India or Pakistan, they come also to Europe to use these master classes to get more experience in their field. We have also in education webinars. This is a very a new concept and also very interactive concept, so you can dial in to a webinar for your specific topic you're interested in, and you can actively interact with a professor or with a person who talks about his specialty. The IBSCU examination, I talked already about that. We have a structured training program and with a core curriculum. In the end, we want to improve the surgical education and training through that. So the ESSO core curriculum responds, in fact, to the lack of many European countries that they don't have, you already heard that, a training program for surgical oncology. So it should help the surgeons to acquire their knowledge, to get more knowledge, and also to shape their skills. So the ESSO contributes from experts and has organ-based and other societies organ-based, and is heading this cancer surgery. The basic principles are relevant to all diseases and site-specific sections. So, as you already heard, the ESSO has a core curriculum, a global curriculum, as well as the American Society of Surgical Oncology, to define the standards. And I just can repeat that line, because the most important thing is to define the standard that you can reach your goal into the training of surgical oncologists worldwide. And the publishing organs, you already heard about that. So, what does it mean here? Just a training and research fellowship. The ESSO supports that. You can visit European centers, or you can also visit centers in the US for a period of time from 3 to 12 months if you apply for this grant. We have collaboration with the Brazilian Society, Latin America, and the United States for a short visiting observership, including the participation of the annual congress and visiting of a specialized center. And I already showed you my experience with the ESSO Fellowship 2016 at the Peritoneal Malignancy Institute in Basingstoke, North Hampshire Hospital. And I can just repeat, this was a wonderful experience for me. I kept friendships with several surgeons from Basingstoke. You see, we had a lot of dinners together. We could exchange our study ideas, also our experience. And in Basingstoke, we were very international. So we had people from Belgium, from Italy, from Greece, from the UK, from the Ukraine, from the Netherlands, from Ireland. So it was a very international fellowship there. I just want to outline, just to show you the possibilities ESSO is providing. So I was summarizing what I found on the webpage, and you see that every year ESSO provides 8 standard training fellowships, meaning that every applicant who is successful gets 1,500 euros, and he can use this money to support his trip from 1 to 3 months, depending on the expenses, to a specialized center. We also have one major training fellowship with a value of 6,000 euro, which allows you for a longer period of time, maybe up to half a year, to visit a specialized center. We have an Isaac Research Fellowship. This is usually meant for the surgeons who are not specialized yet, so that they get in research, in clinical research projects. Many of them are very successful, so they get a publication with a certified center or a specialist center. And it's also a very good way, as I already mentioned, to establish connections in the field of surgical oncology. We also offer fellowships in the breast surgery. In fact, there are, I think, at the moment, 2 breast surgery fellowships for positions in the UK. And the ESSO can also help and help with the network to be successful for also normal fellowship positions in the UK. As you already heard, with the Brazilian Society, there's an observership program for the Congress. In addition, the ESSO also provides Congress travel grants. This is mainly for emerging countries, so poor countries, and participants for the ESSO congresses. And the ESSO is giving and providing grants to support the travel, and also collaboration with the Surgical Society in the US about the annual congress there. We have also several courses about life courses and life surgery. So nearly every European country is providing in their specialty courses where you can attend, where you can have a multidisciplinary approach. You have an international faculty from all over Europe, and it's a perfect way also maybe to get in touch with a specific topic you're interested in, or also in advanced skills training them. And just to show you this slide about the European board qualification, we already heard it's a professional examination, and it exists in several segments. So we also have colorectal surgery, we have general surgery, we have transplantation. So this board qualification exists in many fields, and is based on the curriculum. I continue here because then we have more time to discuss. And this is what I already mentioned. Also, the ESSO implemented 2 school systems, like a masterclass school system for the duration of 2 years training. First of all, the School of Peritoneal Surface Malignancy, which is in collaboration with the SOGI, the Peritoneal Surface Oncology Group International. And many centers provide are host centers in Europe. Also, the center I worked in Berlin, the Charité. And after a curriculum of 2 years with scientific publications, with operations, with your logbook, to state that you were dealing with the patients, with the MDTs, and also the postoperative setup, and then you can apply for this certificate. I will get hopefully the certificate in the end of this year. And the same similar object is with a soft tissue sarcoma surgery, the European School. So also here you have a curriculum of 2 years of certified centers. Many young surgeons go for observership or for a short clinical fellowship to the big centers in Europe, and they are then the hosts of these schools to provide the expertise to learn and to train the young surgeons. What we also have is the webinars. I already mentioned it briefly. So this is very interactive, and I visited them as well. They are really excellent, and they are free of registration. So you have to log in online. You have to make a reservation that you intend to join this webinar. It's very interactive. You can write down questions and interact with the speaker. And you also find on the ESSO homepage a past record of the webinars online, so you can also have a look even already today to see what the offer is. Publications, so the ESSO provides, first of all, for their congresses publications of the abstract, but also for the projects during the schools. You have the possibility to publish your clinical work or your research work in this very important journals. Coming now to the last point of my talk is the ESSO Young Surgeons and Alumni Club, briefly called ISAC. So I'm a member of the ISAC now for a little bit more than 2 years, and I can just tell you it's a wonderful group of young motivated surgeons. We have many different countries of Europe. We also implemented the national representative system, where Aisha is the national representative for Russia, and we are very happy to collaborate with you. And it's a perfect forum, I would say, to have contacts, to talk to other surgeons who are in the same situation as you, or who might give you good ideas or good advice how to overcome maybe one struggle you have in your hospital. It's very useful. So we provide also transfer of knowledge, we improve our surgical oncology training, we have also hands-on ISAC courses, as Dominik already showed you, and I think it's a good way to go abroad or to talk to surgeons abroad outside of your country. And with this slide, I would like to finish. So go online, inform yourself about the program of ESSO. As I already mentioned, there are several possibilities to get support, either for fellowships, for travel. You also saw the LinkedIn and the Twitter account of the Young Surgeons and of ESSO. And I thank you for your attention, and I'm happy for a fruitful discussion.